Hey guys, welcome back to BA Adventures.
Hi.
So today we are discussing all of the fall parties, festivals, pumpkin celebrations and everything at 4 theme parks. So
come with us.
Okay, so before we begin, we want to let you guys know that this video is sponsored by Expedia.com. They are a new affiliation of ours, and you gotta just know who you travel with. You know what I'm saying? but honestly, we are very excited that Expedia has become a part of the BA Adventures group. So we are very excited for that. We have a link in the description box below and on our profile. Use those, and it really helps us out. And helps us bring better quality content to you guys. Yeah. So.
And plus, we actually use Expedia all the time.
Absolutely.
So, never had any problems with them. Actually, they have great customer service. So.
Fantastic customer service. So, anyway, let's jump right into this. Let's jump right to Silver Dollar City.
Our home park.
We couldn't start with any other park. We sat here and talked, and we were like, which one should we start with? Got to be Silver Dollar City. So, Ash, since this is one of your favorite festivals.
It is for Silver Dollar City. Mm-hmm. We experienced it for the first time last year. I loved it. And so, basically, the Harvest Festival is going on from September 15th to October 28th, which is Monday through Fridays, except October 24th.
No, it's Thursday through Monday.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Plus October 24th.
Yes, I'm sorry. Yes. I was thinking ahead. Okay, so... basically, Silver Dollar City is bringing the Harvest Festival to you. Mm-hmm. They're going to have their crafts, their woodworking on the square.
That's those little booths that they had last year. So they're bringing that back, which we thought that was really cool.
Mm-hmm. It's a great time to actually stock up on that Christmas gifts and stuff, because you'll find things that you've never seen before. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Also, there's going to be Cowboy Camp.
Is that something new?
I'm not sure if it's a new, but I have never experienced it. I think we need to add it to our list.
Yeah, we definitely need to go check out Cowboy Camp.
What do you even know what it is?
So apparently they are cooking. It's a cooking demo where you get to sample the food, but it's also a face-off. So it's a face-off. I'm just kidding. But anyway, you get to pick the foods that you thought was better.
Yeah.
It's kind of like
a voting thing.
It's like MasterChef, but it's the cookie.
So the tasting passport's back, which it flavors all things pumpkin. I don't like pumpkin, but I loved the tasting passport for fall.
The only thing that's not pumpkin in there is the cashew chicken cone.
Don't get it. Or is that the one we didn't like?
I don't know. I don't remember off the top of my head.
I immediately said,
if you guys remember that from our other video, like you can see it up here. Go watch it and let us know. It's our bad. So
I just don't remember.
I don't remember either. It's been a year. Slept since then.
Next we've got the Garden of the Giants, which is humongous pumpkins that I've never seen
big. Those giant pumpkins that people need wheelbarrows or dump trucks to bring in.
And they're all naturally grown locally.
Are they really?
I believe so.
Oh, wow. That's awesome.
So it's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. And then we got Pumpkins in the City, which
it's making its return.
Is so much fun. Mm-hmm. There's all things that kids can do there and see. The pumpkin creations are so cool.
Does that mean Foggy Hollow makes its return too? Foggy Hollow.
At one point, we did see him setting up.
Yeah. There was actually our last video where we went camping. We saw them setting up for Foggy Hollow.
Got me so excited.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we got pretty excited. Well, got her excited for it because, it's her favorite festival. So,
another great thing about the Fall Festival is basically the rides are at night. Mm-hmm. And so Mystic Falls is still going to be open until October 29th, which is crazy to me.
Yeah, I feel like it'd be super cold.
But it would be kind of neat to ride at night. I like rides at night because it's a different kind of feel
than
daytime. That's true.
Yeah.
And so if you could ride that at night, that would be so much fun.
I would be.
Maybe you'd see a shark.
Nah. Oh, wait. That's a different park.
We'll get into that one then.
We will get into... No, that's a couple one. Yeah. It's down. Okay. So.
Barry Brown, who is a master pumpkin carver, is also...
I didn't even know that was a thing.
...featured on Good Morning America.
Wow.
He's going to be there. And I think that they kind of do a little show of how to carve, how these pumpkins are carved and the art behind it, which we did not see last year. And I think that needs to be
They may
to
not
notice.
Have had that last year.
They were.
They were there last year? Oh, okay.
Yeah, we just didn't make time to see it, unfortunately. Okay. And I think we need to definitely do that because it'd be kind of cool to see.
Yeah. So Anyway, going back to that pumpkins in the city.
Yeah.
So what do they do with that?
There's a dance party at
A dance party.
I think it's every evening at 5:30.
5:30. Mm-hmm. Okay. And that is located the two way. There are two ways to get there. Number one is through the Grand Exposition. Mm-hmm. And the other one is through Foggy Hollow.
Go that way.
Yeah.
That's the
that,
best.
That is a cool way to enter into that. That would be better. Mm-hmm. And it is located over there by the new Fire in the Hole.
Ooh.
Yes. On the outside of it. You guys, I'm sure you've seen the stage and stuff set up. So it's going to be a great part. And I think, if I remember correctly, Silver Dollar City made a post on Facebook about a giant pumpkin dude, scarecrow guy, possibly going to be there.
It's going to be fun to have a DJ, lights. It's just really cool.
It's a party.
And they've got like characters dressed up as pumpkins. So it's great, like photo opportunities for kids to have a good time.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. What's next?
All right. So that's going to end it for Silver Dollar City. That's all the news for their fall festival. But going to their sister park now of Dollywood, which is located in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. They also have a harvest festival going on. Who would have thought? It goes from September 20th to October 30th. It features a 40-foot pumpkin tree. And glowing pumpkin displays.
And it's different than Star Wars. It's different than Silver City. They're actually really cool looking, I think. You got Dolly's guitar, you have an owl, which is so pretty.
And then are those the ones that those are later on. So the pumpkin flowers things. The sunflower pumpkins.
Oh, yeah, they're so neat.
Are those part of the glow things? Okay. So, yeah, I was right. So, they have these, like, pumpkins that look like sunflowers. It's like the whole stalk and a pumpkin sitting on top in place of the sunflower, which is really neat. They have a glowing tree, too, like a pumpkin tree, the 40-foot pumpkin tree.
And it's all carved into faces.
Is it really? Wow. Okay. So, there's that. And they also do a tasting pass. Not passport. Pass there, which is all things pumpkin. Expect the foods to be very similar between both parks. I mean, they are almost identical. Okay. So there is that. There is also the pumpkin carving by Master Craftsman there as well. They just don't got the Good Morning America dude. But I'm sure they've got some very talented people also who are talented there as well. So we will have to admit we don't know very much about Dollywood's Pumpkin Harvest Festival. We have not experienced it, but we have heard great things. We do plan to experience it in the future. I know Ash wants to go because she really likes Silver Dollar Cities. So
Why wouldn't you, right?
Exactly. So all right, so the next park moving on from Dollywood is
Universal Studios.
Not Islands of Adventure.
No, just Universal.
Just Universal Studios. HHN has kicked off.
Yeah.
Which is abbreviated for Halloween Horror Nights.
This is not a kid-friendly environment.
No, it is not.
Unless your child is mature enough to do so.
Correct. Yeah, if you have an older child who can handle, like,
blood, guts,
haunted
and
houses.
Gore.
Yeah. There are 10 haunted houses, all themed differently of different Universal IPs. That's what they call them. So one of them is Stranger Things 4.
Which I think Stranger Things 4 season 4 was like one of the best seasons. So I would definitely want to go into that house and look at it.
We look forward to experiencing HHN. We watch a lot of other YouTubers with this.
Yes.
And we do our own research and we really want to go so bad. But, you know, being in Missouri, we can't go every day, unfortunately. But that being said, another one is Exorcist Believer.
The new movie that's coming out.
Yes, the new Exorcist movie is on its way. Go ahead.
Oh, I was going to jump to The Last of
Us. Oh, The Last
of Us. That's an amazing house idea. Yeah.
It was one of the top games at its time, whenever it was in its heyday, which wasn't very long ago. And then the show kicked it off so well. And even the voices, like the voice actors from those characters came back and did the voices for like Ellie and
in the haunted house. Yeah, so mm-hmm. that's super cool.
Yeah, that was awesome. And then they've got another one is Chucky. Chucky is another theme for one. Mm-hmm. You know, the doll from hell. Scary. See, then you got your classic Universal monsters, which
I think that's so cool. You know, I would be about that mm-hmm. one.
The Mummy, Frankenstein, mm-hmm. werewolf, the, mm-hmm. all of those.
Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde's in Dr. there. Jekyll. Yeah.
Okay, and then this one is actually kind of based around the entire theme of HHN, and yes. that is Dr. Oddfellow,
who has like a backstory going on. Mm-hmm. He's kind of the main character within it
of HHN. Yeah,
yeah. And he looks so cool.
Yeah, he does. Yeah, I would like to see that. Mm-hmm. And do you go do you go through his like laboratory?
I'm not sure what's in the house.
Okay, I'm not sure either. I thought I heard that at mm-hmm. one point, but maybe not. And then this is something that some of you OG Islands of Adventure people will know about, and I also think that this is kind of like a hint towards something coming at Epic Universe. Dueling Dragons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of choose your own fate is mm-hmm. what it said.
Yeah. So, from what we've read, you can pick two paths. Is it red and blue?
Yes.
Yep, you can pick a red path or a blue path, and they're different. Mm-hmm. So, that I think is kind of neat. You get two options there. But the reason that I think something like that is coming to Epic Universe is due to the fact of How to Train Your Dragon.
Yeah.
There is a coaster there, but I don't know if it's going to be a dueling type. I know there's a dueling, like, mm-hmm. star ride there, but I think it would be really cool if they had a dueling, like,
dragon
race, because, like, they had that show Race to the Edge or whatever. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
The next ones are going to be the original ideas of Darkest Deal, Blood Moon, and the Yeti.
Mm-hmm. So, don't know much about those. Mm-mm. So, nope. We haven't seen a whole lot on those. They may not be quite as popular as the other ones. So, there are also places called Scare Zones at HHN. So, this is if you've never experienced this. So to explain what they are areas inside Universal Studios, which we do not know their exact location. I mean, we could find their exact location if you look on the map when you get there. But we don't know them off the top of our head. But Dr. Oddfellow, these areas are places that you can walk through and you can have like little jump scares. Or I know that there is a place that would be Ashley's favorite street of nothing but chainsaws.
They don't have that this year.
They don't have, that's a travesty. That's... No, it's just not right.
I feel like we should have went this year.
No,
would have been the
definitely
year.
Not. The year that they bring it back is the year that we'll go the first time. And it'll be the first street that we go down. Universal. So.
And we'll probably be done. But anyways, those five scare zones are based around Dr. Oddfellow mm-hmm. and kind of his storyline. Mm-hmm. So you have the Dr. Oddfellow area. Mm-hmm. You also have Dark Zodiac, Jungle of Doom, Vamp 69, meaning vampire. And
I wonder if that's like he tried cloning a vampire or something and it took him 69 tries.
Well, I think it's like the hippie, like, peace kind of zone with vampires. It looked really cool. Don't judge it.
I did not. I haven't seen it. But hippies and vampires to me doesn't seem like it would go well.
It looks cool. You just have faith in HHN.
Okay.
Because it's like a cult. and then you've also got the Shipyard of 32.
Yep. Now, this is a separate ticketed event, mm-hmm. Which is completely different from what Dollywood and Silver Dollar City do.
Yeah.
Basically, what they do is they close the park, and then if you have HHN tickets, then you can go into the park. Mm-hmm. All rides are operating at this time. You can ride them. Mm-hmm.
Really
Ash doesn't
low
think
wait times.
Very low wait times. Yeah. So, honestly, if it were me... some rides that I would like to ride if I were there would be Rip Ride Rocket because it's at night.
Yeah, that would be kind of cool.
The Mummy because it's a classic monster.
Yeah.
And that's it. So.
I would not want to waste my time. Mm-hmm. Time is precious at HHN. And mm-hmm. you want to get in all the scares that you can because
yeah.
in the foods and all
yeah,
that
Yeah, they have
stuff.
Exclusive food and drink. Mm-hmm. That was the other thing I was going to say is they have exclusive food and drink. for you there at these things, at this ticketed event. I'm not sure what the price of that ticket is off the top of my head. So
we'll put it in there.
we'll put it up here somewhere in the editing. Or you guys can comment below and let us know. So anyway, the first time ever this is going to happen in Diagon Alley, and that is Death Eaters are making their appearance.
Which is super cool.
It is. I don't know why it's taken them this long, though.
Well, I know that they would pop in here and there, but, like, mm-hmm. I think it's an exclusive for HHN. But they're like, hi, here they are. Yeah. You know, and, mm-hmm. and there's, like, a show. There's, you know, kind of smoke and mm-hmm. let's see you in the fog kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it's really cool, and I feel like that would make it worthwhile as well.
Definitely. Definitely. So... and then they have one show mm-hmm. aside from the Death Eater one that's going on, and that is called Nightmare Fuel Revenge Dream.
Yeah, and so, it looks really cool.
Did it?
It was like metal music and metal. Fire and dancing and trapeze kind of looking stuff. It looked really neat.
Trapeze. Like people flipping around.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. Alright, so switching gears here and going over to Disney World, which is also located in Orlando. We're switching gears in the fact that we go from a horror, scary vibe to a Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween has made its return to Magic Kingdom.
I love this little mm-hmm. party. I've been there twice. It's so much fun. Mm-hmm.
And when does it go from?
It goes from, well, it's already started in August 11th, which is so early. And it will go until November 1st, which is mm-hmm. kind of late to me. I don't know why. When I hit November, I'm like, well, this is done.
It's just a day after
it
Halloween.
It is,
so.
It's so strange to me. Yeah. Well. I'm like November and it's like Christmas, but that's me. So anyway,
that's fair. Yeah.
The entertainment that we have this year is going to be the Not So Scary Spectacular, which is
Not
the,
So Spooky Spectacular.
Oh, I'm sorry. which is the fireworks show and the projector and the lasers, which is super cool on the mm-hmm. castle. Then you got the Hocus Pocus villain, Spelltacular, which is not spooktacular. And Jack is there, Oogie Boogie, all your great villains are going to be there.
Yeah, all the villains are going to make their appearance. Captain Hook,
Maleficent,
yes.
Cruella, I mean the best of
Dr.
the best.
Dr. Vassilier. Mickey's Boo to You Halloween Parade.
Boo to you! Oh, this song gosh. Is stuck in my head. Has been stuck in my head since August, probably. I love this song. It's the funnest song. But anyways, this parade is fantastic. You see all the characters just in their Halloween costumes. Mm-hmm. And you just have a great time, and this song will be stuck in your head for the rest of your life, like me.
Yeah. So, some special things about this. This is a separately ticketed mm-hmm. event, which we also don't know the exact price for. I think the price actually fluctuates day to day.
It does. The closer you get to Halloween, the higher it goes up. Mm-hmm. Kind of like pretty traditional for parks to do that.
Yeah. And I also think that HHN is the same way.
Yep.
So, that is also why we don't know the exact price, but it can fluctuate. Mm-hmm. It's not cheap. So, just saying.
You're paying for what you get.
You are paying for what you get. So, something that you can do in the park is you can trick-or-treat throughout the park to various locations, which are located on a map. They give you a map mm-hmm. when you go in. And you can go to these places and get candy. And we did watch another YouTuber go through this. And he was getting like handfuls of candy just dumped into
it. And we're talking the good candy.
Yeah.
Not the candy that you get trick-or-treating door-to-door.
No, not the itty-bitty stuff. We're talking at least mm-hmm. regular-sized candy just thrown into it. And we're just... I'm sitting here thinking like, dang. So, so you get to do that. You also get to wear your costumes. Not only the children and kids get to wear them, but mm-hmm. adults can dress up too. It is the only time of the year that you can do that. And now, since it is a separately ticketed event,
yeah.
it's only during that time that you can do that, correct?
Absolutely. Only so. During the Halloween party is when you can dress up as an adult and live your best life.
So, and then you also, like Ash said, you get to see your favorite characters dress in their Halloween costumes. And I honestly, the colors this year are kind of cool.
Yeah, actually, I really like it. It's so neat.
Mm-hmm. I like the addition of the teal mm-hmm. color in there. It looks good with the orange and the black and the purple and the yellow.
It feels very retro to me, like mm-hmm. very like 80s-esque, and I like it.
Yep. And then there is something that Ash really wishes that she could get, and we're hoping that when we go, that it's at the Disney character warehouses. We're like,
crossing
our fingers. We're also crossing all of our toes just to see if we can get there and it be there. Highly doubtful because of how popular this popcorn bucket is.
It is so cool.
So we'll let you in on a little secret of Ashley's. Her favorite Disney movie is?
Well, it's up there. Nightmare Before Christmas.
Okay, well, it's up there.
Well, I mean, it's not the favorite, but yes.
Okay, it's very high up on the list.
Yes.
It's like in the top two.
Yeah. So. Yes, exactly.
So, that being said, it is Lock, Shock, and Barrel mm-hmm. driving.
Like a van.
It's the mayor's van yeah. that he drives around and making the announcements.
Mm-hmm. He's so, like... Mm-hmm. I have a couple buckets that are Nightmare Before Christmas, and my favorite one is a Zero one where he's in his doghouse, mm-hmm. and then I have an Oogie Boogie one. But the detail that they have put into this bucket and made it look so much fun and so neat, I would give my left pointing finger for it.
Your left?
Well, my right, because I have, you know,
yeah,
well, you have pick your nose. No, I'm just kidding. But anyways.
No, I'm just kidding.
That it is such a cool bucket. Great yeah, job, is. Disney, for being like super creative. And I'm surprised it's still mm-hmm. available. Like, I figured that's like a fly yeah. off the popcorn buckets.
Yeah. Just keep your eyes on Shop Disney, but don't take too many of them. We're watching you while you're watching us. So. But anyway, so that's going to wrap up all of our parks that we wanted to talk about today. Mm-hmm. This video was very fun to make. Actually, we were really excited about the fall and Halloween.
It's one of the best times to go to the parks.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, I like the temperature that it is, especially here in Missouri at Silver Dollar City. Mm-hmm. You can start the day off, it's kind of warm, but then as the day goes on, you get that nice cool breeze and the temperature starts dropping and you get to wear your hoodie and your sweaters. And, you know, I mean, my favorite thing to wear is a hoodie and shorts and, I don't know, maybe I'm weird, but, like, it's hoodie and shorts weather time. I'm ready for it. So, just saying. I mean, obviously, I'm in my spirit jersey for Disney World, which I have hunted for years, and I finally found one this summer. Thank you, Poshmark. So, anyway, that being said... If you guys want to keep up on more of our theme park videos and news and updates and tips and tricks and all of those things, especially the food and stuff,
yeah.
and how to just have a great time at all these theme parks that we go to, hit that like button, that subscribe button, and that
bell notification button
so that you guys don't miss any more of our theme park videos, especially the ones for the fall. And with that,
bring on the next adventure.
Bye, guys. We'll be right back.